Philippine Senator Risa Ontiveros calls on the Commission on Higher Education to investigate reports of so-called ghost scholars. Ontiveros reveals she received complaints. Some students who already graduated are still included in CHED's scholarship program. Ontiveros adds, while tuition reimbursements have already been given out to these ghost scholars, hundreds of students are still waiting for their education subsidy. Now, for more on that story, we'll talk to CHED Chairperson Prospero De Vera III. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, good afternoon.
Now, sir, about these ghost scholars, this is just one of the three issues that Senator Ontiveros has brought up during the hearing Tuesday, I think, or Wednesday. But first, would you like to clear up, I guess, the air and also clarify with these allegations on the ghost scholars receiving money even though they have already graduated?
Any allegations of so-called ghost scholars can be resolved only if the names, the degree programs, the school where they come from, and evidence is presented so that CHED can investigate them one by one. You know, it's easy to complain and it's easy to accuse, but by law, we have to observe due process and the names have to be given to us with the full information. So far, the office, our office have not received any list, have not received any evidence. So I am not in position to say whether there are ghost scholars or not.
Will you be holding investigations, sir, if there are?
Of course, we've been investigating allegations for the past 6 years already. If there are any complaints, the office tracks the alleged student, talks with the school to look at the records and check it with our records, whether they are qualified or not.
Sir, are you still with us?
No, we have to get the names, we have to get the information, and we have to get the evidence. One person saying that another person is not qualified does not allow us to automatically exclude certain individuals.
Sir,
so
what's
have
the,
to get
what,
the names.
Sir?
Where are the names?
Okay. Well, with regards to, of course, what are the names, sir, what is the protocol when it comes to these things? Of course, it's Senator Ontiveros who has presented, of course, these allegations, as you call it. Will CHED be working with Senator Ontiveros and her office when it comes to the investigation of this?
Yeah, I already asked the office of Senator Ontiveros to forward to us names, the information, and the evidence last month. We have not received any. So what is there to investigate if we don't have the necessary information?
So I would like to clarify on that. You have already reached out on this issue last month, but her office has not yet responded.
Yes, because we talked by Zoom. She filed a resolution to investigate alleged anomalies in the implementation of free higher education. And we said we are open to any investigation and we would like to see the list of alleged students who are not qualified. We need the list, we need the schools, we need the degree programs, we need the evidence to show they are not qualified.
Okay, now that issue about ghost scholars have been addressed, the second anomaly that she has presented is the 1 billion Park funds on a defunctive MOA since 2019.
Well, I already answered that in the Senate hearing yesterday. The problem of the student loan program is that first, CHED is not an agency that has a capability to implement student loan programs. We are not a government financial institution. We have no legal basis to go after students who don't pay, etc. And the best evidence of this is previously there was a Study Now, Pay Later program implemented by CHED, and the repayment rate was less than 10%. The best agencies to implement a loan program are government financial institutions. Unfortunately, RA 10931 said that CHED should implement one. So we entered into an agreement with the Development Bank of the Philippines for a student loan program. And the student loan program was launched. There were very few applications. And later on, when we studied it, we saw certain defects in the system that we signed together with the DBP. So we attempted to negotiate with the DBP on changing the structure of the program. But that did not materialize. So when the COA observation came out, we immediately informed DBP to just return the money and the interest to the National Treasury.
So, and that is, sir, just to clarify that, before you proceed with that story, so that 1 billion Park funds since 2019 has been returned to the National Treasury, including the interest.
So I don't know why we are being accused of parking money. It has been returned to the National Treasury. There is no CHED money parked anywhere. The money has been returned to the National Treasury already, together with the interest, upon the instruction of the Commission when we received the COA audit observation in the middle of this year. So there is no parked money. I do not know what is the definition of parked money.
Thank you for clarifying that.
It is in the National Treasury already. We can send you the receipt if you want that it is with the National Treasury.
Okay, sir. Thank you for that. Now, the third anomaly is the $7 billion worth of questionable releases. Again, Senator Ontiveros is saying that her office has received emails containing screenshots of the UNIFAS Facebook page urging students to stand by CHED scholarship program. And they were actually, I wouldn't say forced, but they were encouraged to post. But they felt like they were being gaslighted. Any reactions to this?
Well, I do not know what she's talking about, but it is the right of every beneficiary of free higher ed to air their sentiments about how the program has helped them. Maybe what the media should focus on is to listen to the success stories of the beneficiaries who are saying that free higher education has helped them. That is their right under a democratic system to say whatever they think about government programs, in the same way that it is the right of Senator Ontiveros if there is basis to criticize the program. So I do not know what is wrong with the beneficiaries of free higher ed airing their sentiment that they fully support the program.
I thought we lived in
a democratic country.
Sir Devera, what do you think of these anomalies that were brought about by Senator
Ontiveros? There are no anomalies. I have been saying this repeatedly. What Senator Ontiveros did was to total all the funds which are COA audit observations. I repeat, these are COA audit observations. These are not disallowances. What COA audit observation means is that there are problems or deficiencies in the procedure, in the documents, etc. We are ready to rebut and refute this in any forum because we have responded to the COA audit observations already. For example, it says there are no official receipts. The official receipts have been given to COA. As far as we're concerned, we've submitted our response to the COA audit observations as required by law within 6 months after the COA audit observation comes out. We have submitted our response to the COA. If you want to read through it, we will be happy to give a copy of our response to the COA audit observation. Again, let me repeat, these are not allegations of corruption or fund misuse. At all, these are COA audit observations.
CHED Chairperson Prospero De Vera III, sir, thank you so much for your time.
Okay, thank you.